welcome back. Thanks for tuning in. Chris Tran for Guns and Tactics. I'm here with Justin from Fortis Manufacturing.
Listen, good to see you, man.
See
thanks
you.
So much for having us
thanks
back at the booth.
Us.
Oh, yeah, I really appreciate it. We had three different products that we wanted to talk about today. And
yes,
I know
sir.
Some of them in production, kind of researching, trying
yes.
to figure out exactly how I
yep.
want to do it. On the first, I think it was what you guys are calling the K1. Is that right?
K1, that
okay.
is correct.
So what do we have going on with the K1?
So with the K1 design, this is our, what we would call a two-piece.
Okay.
So we have our castle nut, mm-hmm. and we have our back plate. So featured on our back plate is the full 360-degree QD mounting system.
Yep.
And also we have, this is our friction lock castle nut. So it's 15 to 20 pound torque. No staking, no ratcheting, and this will not back out.
And that's because you've obviously got a lot more surface area that's going on here because
correct.
This is your beveled in, right?
Full 360 degrees of contact, and it is locked in place.
Pretty clever. Now, you guys done yep. some testing on this yet? I mean, you have
well,
any rattles
around still,
too?
We're still doing some testing as far as... still doing some testing.
Okay,
yes.
makes sense. We'll see yep. how that comes out. So that's in development.
Correct.
We'll see how this goes, but again, just shows like how forward-thinking you guys are
yep.
in terms of what's out
so
there.
So this will be our first of the two that will be released.
Super cool.
Yes.
All right, so that means that this is probably almost there.
And we're close.
Excellent.
Real close.
And that's the K1. Now, the second system, what do you call this one?
So this is the... This is the K2 system. So
weird.
This is, yeah, one
yeah.
and right. then two.
It's strange.
So this is our three-piece, and I guess the significance of this is that you would just snug it up.
Yep.
You could do another 15 to 20 pounds of torque, not very much. And then how it is placed is you find the respective points underneath. As you can tell, there's these
sure.
little
get this little
detents.
Yep.
You take your Omega clip or your C clip, insert it to the channel,
huh.
and it will then lock that in place.
Got it.
So there is no way for this to back out.
So no need to stake.
No,
just
sir.
Making sure that you got that cleared up the way that you need to.
No.
And then if you have to change it, if you're swapping some stuff out without
yep.
screwing up a bunch
yep.
of metal, you can just pop that C clip
correct.
Right on out.
Correct. Yep.
And also very clever. So that's going to be coming out second once that development is done. And then the last one. So this one I'm super interested in for a
okay.
couple different reasons. But go ahead.
Please.
Okay. So the reason why I'm interested in these is because I see some failures sometimes, especially if you're running some classes, you've got some folks trying out new gear, they've slapped on, you know, oh, I need an ambi safety selector, and, you know, we've sometimes seen these wings shear off, or we've seen the
yes.
screws back off, and when you're in
correct.
The middle of a shooting class going on for a week, to have a rifle go down because your safety pops out and off.
Okay.
Never a good thing. So I was very intrigued by these because it looks like Fortis took a little bit of a different approach to these ambi safety selectors. So
yes.
Can you walk us through like, what
sure
the design
thing.
Is on these?
I'm glad you pointed that out.
Yeah.
So what we've done here, this is our SS50
okay.
safety selector. So this is full ambi, and we have made it to where it's actually on the same barrel. We have the 90-degree selector
yeah.
and a 50-degree selector, SS50.
So it's two-in-one, right.
And
okay, cool.
As you pointed out, we do not have the set screw that attaches the levers to the barrel itself.
Right.
So there's no way for it to back out.
Okay.
And how our main attachment is through this ridge key
right there.
Yep. design. So that is your main contact.
Look at this thing.
And the set screws are underneath and will attach it.
Got it. That makes perfect sense.
And keep
so,
it from rotating.
So that keeps things from getting shorn off on the sides in terms of the wings of the leaves out the side.
Correct.
Pat pending on this side on the
yep.
on the inside for that
yes.
or patent
yes.
for that mechanism
yes.
in there, and then it just screws down here on the ends.
Correct.
Super smart. Definitely waiting for these to come
yeah.
out. So unfortunately, this is going to be the third
me
one
too.
Out of them, but that is something
yeah.
I'm very interested in checking. And I really like the 50-degree. I don't know what it is about the 45 versus the 50, but the 50
yeah.
just seems to feel
yeah.
really, really well for my hand.
Agree.
So that's awesome. Fortis, you guys are always trying to come up with something new. I mean, that's one of the things that we love about your company is that, you know, it's definitely out there in terms of the concept of designs,
yep.
but you really, really are always trying to push things forward for us.
Appreciate
so really
that.
Appreciate it.
Appreciate the feedback.
Thanks for having us at the booth.
Thanks for being here.
All right, man. And if we wanted to learn more about Fortis Manufacturing,
sure.
where do we go?
FortisManufacturing.com. Feel free to email us or just call with any questions that you may have.
That is awesome.
Yep.
And tune in for more TriggerCon coverage. Chris Tran for Guns and Tactics. Check us out on social media and the web at Guns and Tactics. We'll be back with you. Just make sure you guys hit that notification button so you know when our next videos are coming out. We really appreciate you guys following us. Doing the best we can for you at TriggerCon 2018. Thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you.